Today we are going to see operations on array, and in this today we will see the delete operation of the array. In previous videos we have seen the traversing operation, then we have seen the insertion operation, and today we will see the delete operation. So actually in case of the array, if we want to delete a particular element, is nothing but what, in that position we have to copy the next element, or we have to just overwrite that element. That is nothing but what, the deletion of any element from the array, because array is nothing but what, the static declaration is there. So that's why, as we are going to allocate the memory at the compile time, so it is not possible for us to delete a particular element totally from the memory. So just we have to overwrite in that position. That is nothing but what, the deletion in case of the array. So now we will take one example. Here I have taken one array which is going to contain the 5 elements, that is the 2, 4, 6, 8 and 9, and the 0, 1, 2, 3, 4 is nothing but what, the index locations are there. So now suppose I want to delete this 4, that is nothing but this element which is present at the second location, but the index position is what, the 1 is there. So if we want to delete this 4 from this array, means actually what we have to do here, in this position we have to copy this next element. That means, in short, what we have to do here, we have to shrink the array. So how to shrink here? In place of this 4, we have to copy this next element, that is the 6. In place of this 6, we have to copy this next element, that is the 8. And in place of this 8, we have to copy the next element, that is nothing but the 9 is there. So in this way we have to shift the array to the left side here. That means we have to shrink the size of the array. So how we can do this? So I have written here the code. Here whatever the variables I have taken here, this A array is nothing but array name is there. N is nothing but the total number of elements present in this array. Like in this case, N is equal to 5 is there initially. Then position is nothing but the variable which is going to contain the index location. Actually we are going to say, like I am saying, like I want to delete the element from the second location, third location, fourth location, like this way. But position is nothing but what, I am accepting here the index location from which I want to delete the value. So like in this case, the position is nothing but what, the 1 is there. I want to delete from the second position, but the index location is the 1, so that's why the position value is 1 here. Now what we have to do here, next element we have to copy in the previous position. So if you see here, we have taken here the for loop. In that for loop, this is the counter variable I we have taken. We have initialized it to the position, that means from which we want to delete the element. I is less than n minus 1 condition I have taken here. N is nothing but the total number of elements here. And what we are doing, if the condition is true, a of I is equal to a of I plus 1. That means next position element we are going to copy to the previous position. So now we will see how this works here. Initially our position is equal to 1, n is equal to 5. So I will become here what, the 1. N is what, the 5. 5 minus 1 is what, 4. So 1 is less than 4, condition is true. So what we will do here now, a of I is equal to a of I plus 1. That means what here? A of 1 is equal to a of I plus 1 is 1 plus 1, that is the 2. That means what, a of 2 value is what, the 6. So a of 1 is equal to 6. That means this operation we will perform here. This 6 we will copy in place of this 4 here. Okay. Next, I plus plus is there. So now I will become the 2 here. N is as it is 5 minus 1, that is the 4. So 2 is less than 4, again the condition is true. So now what we will do here, a of 2 is equal to a of 3. So a of 3 is what here, the 8, that we will copy now in place of this 6 here. So it will be copied here, that is the a of 2 is equal to 8. Next, again I plus plus is there, now I will become the 3. 3 again is less than the 4, condition is true. So now what we will do here, a of 3 is equal to a of 4. A of 4 is nothing but what, the 9, that we have to copy in place of this 8. So this 8 will be overwritten with the 9 here. So a of 3 is equal to 9 will become here. Next, again I plus plus is there. Now I will become the 4. Now whenever I will become the 4, the condition I is less than 4, that means 4 is less than 4, will get false here, and execution of this for loop will stop here. And if you see here, all values we have shifted to the left side and our array becomes like this way. 2, 6, 8 and 9, these are the new 4 elements inside the array now. So this is our the new array after deleting of the 4. In place of the 4, 6 is coming. In place of 6, 8 and in place of the 8, 9 is coming. So now our array size is shrink here from the 5 to 4 here. So after this for loop, we have to write here like the n is equal to n minus 1. Because now the total number of elements reduced by 1. So we have to change this value of the n here. So that after whenever we are going to print the array, then in that case our whatever be the new value for the n, that will become the 4 and we will get the only 4 print. We will print only the first 4 values there. So this is nothing but what the deletion of any particular element from the array. So hope by this example and by this code you have understood the concept of the deletion of the array. Only what we have to remember here, deletion from the array is nothing but what, in place of the deleted element, next element we have to copy. So in short, we have to shrink the size of the array. Each and every element we have to shift to the left side till that position here. So this is the logic behind the deletion of the array. So hope you have understood this deletion concept. So thank you for watching this video.